Welcome, fellas. How's this going? So I know I discussed doing this yesterday, but the game didn't release till today. That was my fart part for being stupid. My fault for being stupid. But hey, it's a new series, new game. I know we had a little bit of a series going on with MLB The Show 21, 22. I was just completely skipped out on. We're back for MLB The Show 23. Now, the career mode is going to be the base sort of series that I'm gonna do. I might do cocky ball player, depending on if I feel up to it. But for sure, we're gonna go or attempt to go several seasons through with just a regular playthrough up. Now, I have played the game. That's just to kind of get my get through the intro, do my setting adjustments and all that. I've also somewhat started a Diamond Dynasty just to get feel of the game, but I didn't want to play too much and just leave y'all like, yeah, this is just easy. Because honestly, I did not play much of 22 either, to be honest. Anyways, new road to the show, new Flair Vanetti ball player. Player. And I always try to stray away from the pitcher because that's just what everybody typically does. So we're going position player. I think I had him as a power in 22. I know 21 he was fielder. I liked running with the power, however. Of course, pitchers are going to be locked out for this. And instead, we can have catcher all the way through. And y'all know me, I like playing my shortstop. So, yeah, a good part of the episode today will be creating the player. I mean, of course, we're also gonna go through with an actual, like, getting into the majors and such as well. Yes, I know there's not going to be any sounds to this name. Doesn't matter, anyways. Because. Oh, that was the actual names. Because. Gonna go with a good old crash train. This is what I think I did for every single time I've done this. Number, of course, 48. Right-handed, region west. Or no, not region west, region east. Sorry. Fuck the West Coast. And if you're from there, no hate to you. I just hate the West Coast mainly. Looking good. Not Marty to general info. Here's the fun part. Skin tone. White as hell. Height. 6'6". Weight. 245. Husky body type. Large neck. Get some freaking legs on this man. Head shape. There it is. Forehead wrinkles, meh. Ears. Where's wrinkles? Or not wrinkles, but okay. Gonna just have to. We'll find freckles eventually. And I've already done this. That is my hair, the wild shag, though mine is a little bit longer. Long suave. Yeah, I think that one's a little bit better. You need to have a bit of orangish in there, about that. Gonna go with nut, mainly because of the fact of this. Scruffy, medium length. That's actually just about mine, except for the fact that I've got more of a beard on the bottom. Thick chin strap. There it is. That's what we got, boys. And then finally, there. That's a flare. Sideburns. Yeah, you really can't tell anything there. Because of the beard. And we don't even need a style 4, to be honest. Beard is also oranger. Blemishes, none. Moles, none. Skin complexion, freckles, max it out. Eye color. Ten. Eye bags. Not gonna lie, I've got bad eye bags. Curvy long? Yes. And then that is it for my looks. Now it's on to equipment. Uniform, no turtleneck. Then silver necklace. Which is what I actually wear. I have one on now. Jersey sleeve length. 45-ish. Now, that's how I wear mine. I don't like the bagginess of what it typically gives you. We go with a black basket glove, light brown. Finger out of the glove, yes. Glove underneath, yes. It's a glove the bat. I believe I went... I can't remember, but... I think this is what we'll run with. Tape, I don't use tape. Tarpine, yes. Barrel ring, yes, I actually like the barrel ring on it. And then I match that with the logo, I just think that looks better. Batting gloves, both. Main color is one. Other color is two. Wrist is three. Knuckle is three. Gloves and pocket on both. I've actually done that in real life. Rawlings Mach Pro, that's an actual helmet that I had. The older generations of it was a lot more. Tarpine, no. Cat style, low profile, with a curved brim. Elbow guard, nope. Never used guards. Don't use armband. Sleeves, both. As above elbow, compression sleeve on the left. Full length. the team's second color. I don't have it on the right. Don't use wrist tape. Eyewear, always on cap. It is normal. Or, yeah, just fielding, rather, not always. Rim color red. Just because that's the actual glasses I've had. Cleats. Just like that. Catcher's mask, I don't gotta worry about. And that's it for equipment. Motion and sounds. Now this is what takes forever. There we go. Hand rotation. I always forget about. That's just a pain in the butt. In all honesty. Running style. More lean down. One-handed style. Three. Yep. Practice swing. There you go. Stride. I always have that big hike. Take a pitch. The strike. Yep. Just the look at and nod. Now I can't do any of that. Rather I can. There's a specific one I'm looking for. It's coming around off the base. It's not that one. Is it this one? Nope. There it is. Music. Country, classic rock, modern rock. Where's that? Don't gotta worry about that. I don't have those. And that is it. That's kind of just the build done. Now it's time to start. I've not seen any of these, by the way. And it looks like he's going to get that call. Getting drafted is a dream come true. You now have the opportunity to play in the major leagues. You're in a major league system. Hard work and preparation, you can climb the ladder.
You have to ask yourself, are you willing to do what it takes to battle every day, to get the job done? To get your team over the top. And this game is turned upside down. Are you willing to take that chance?
A perfect game.
Oh, I can't wait. You talk about a guy who comes much advertised. This is it. I am raring to go. Let's watch.
You hear about certain people who have potential, have great potential, and they go out there every day and prove it. You bet I'll be watching. We might be watching generational talent. Journey begins now.
The journey does begin now, indeed. Draft already underway. A young prospect gets a call from an experienced scout. This is from the Guardians. Was hoping to talk about possible. What do you say? Fuck yes, I want to play. Perfect. Let's get to it. Where do you see yourself in this year's draft? Honestly, I just want to make it into the league. Let's make it happen. Would you want to play for the Guardians? Since I chose that as my team, of course I am a Cleveland fan. I have the Vinetti 48 Cleveland Guardians shirt and plus a hoodie and several Indians hats along with, I believe, it's one Guardians hat. Now, here's where I'm caught up. Do I want to just say, yeah, let's go play for Cleveland and throw out Amedeo Rosario from shortstop? Do I always just want to go to a random team? You know what? Let's just go to a random team. Well, there, what does your future in baseball look like? Whether you're on our team or another. Right, I'm thinking of Hall of Fame and a World Series championship. Yep. Personally, I like your energy. We want you in our dugout. I know you're busy and have all 30 clubs trying to talk to you. Probably. So, let's do see, in fact, where I do end up. Okay. That's one hell of a... The Nationals? I'll take it. I will honestly take that. You must be kidding. They're not bad.
They drafted who? We had this circus last year.
Oi, fucking Wanka. Doesn't believe in me. Oh boy. Skill set. Speedy, you're sparking slip. Okay, so that gives me added contact as sparking. Speedy gives me the added speed. That gives me added fielding. I think I'm gonna go with speed here. Play style. Oh, yes, all my perks. Okay. Definitely adding contact. Since I went with speed, I think I'm going to add the fielding as well. Since I already have the base speed added on to me. You know what? I'll take that as a start. Nope. I'll take it. That's not too bad in all honesty as a starter. So, looking at the calendar, here comes April. You've got, which becomes the Red Sox, Richmond, which becomes, who is that? Don't know who Richmond becomes. That becomes the Guardians.
Getting your first hit out of the way, your first at bat, takes a lot of pressure off. The first time stepping into the Oakland Coliseum, I was nervous. You know, I'm facing Dave Stewart. You know, I faced him one time in spring training prior to that. And now everything that you dreamed about, you know, being in the big leagues, being in the show, you know, I walk up there as second hitter, and I'm looking like, oh my, I'm finally here. And he could have rolled a ball and probably swung at it.
Honestly, that's probably what I will do. Try to make anything as big as possible. It's the pitchers. Patrick Corbin. That's Sawyer. Well, here we go. First game.
Glad you're with us. Opening day baseball on the show. It's the Harrisburg Senators and the Somerset Patriots. First pitch coming your way now.
That's pathetic.
All right, just about set to go. this one, Matt Sauer. Chris, how about a scouting report?
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to bring something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time.
Oh, my arm sucks.
Something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back.
Why are they going back and forth?
You really have to stay on your toes.
So clean up.
And first offering is fouled off.
Also, yes, I do play with the ball guesser.
One and one. Come on, baby. Get your pitch up. Stay through. Let's go.
In the air, right field. Number 10 settles under it. One away.
See, I never have fully understood why that's power when that's more so contact.
Now at the plate, 0-1 so far.
Hey, come on now. One time.
And the first offering is not close.
Hitter's got some good opposite.
Curveball like that will never get me.
I like about something being hit.
It's always been the sliders. Come on, man.
Is it the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base.
Inside four seam. Fair play.
And a count one and two. Second and third here. One away. On the ground, right.
I'll take the RBI though.
And here's the first baseman, number 59. He's 0-1. The 0-1. Out to short. Train collects.
I was not going to be able to make it. If I tried to do that play at second base, he was too fast.
Back here at the ballpark. And now the shortstop crash. Train.
Come on, let me at least get a hit first game, please. There we go. Batting triple threes is not bad.
First baseman, number 10.
Frankie Tostado.
0-2 now. On the ground to third. He dives, but he can't make the catch. And he beats it. He's safe.
Is that an error? Is that going to be a base hit? It's a base hit.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity. Right on top of it.
Can't glove it cleanly. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Now one gone in the top of the sixth.
I will say, this kind of like frame, per se, like how everything's shown during the game, I like more than 22. But with like when it came to my player's stuff and when I was messing with like perks and everything, I'd much prefer the 22 one.
Sometimes all you gotta do is your job.
And now the
first hit and first run scored within the first game. I think I'd be satisfied with that.
Hey, one away.
Back to work, 3-2 now. On the ground left side, 6-4-3.
Hit him. There we go.
That'll do it for the inning.
They made it look easy.
Really, that's an assist.
A couple of lefties this inning.
Train stands in now and watches.
That was a good slider. I'll give him that. That was a very well placed slider.
Left field, way back there. Gone. The big
home run first game.
And they add to their lead. It's 5-3. And a nice moment for him.
Oh, that's amazing.
Certainly remember that's his first double A home run.
That is amazing. I did not expect that to come early.
A nice relief, and not just for him, but for the organization as well.
Honestly, I didn't even expect it to make it like that. I thought he was going to get me. His
first save of the season is in the books, and that was a nice job of him coming in the game and closing it out. He's off and running now.
I will honestly take that as a first game. And look at the attributes increase. That's amazing. That's what you love to see. You want to see the green. You don't want to see the red in the slightest. It's also kind of hard to get red when you're first starting. These intros are amazing. I have, just let me say that. These intros to the games are amazing.
Here's the shortstop at the plate.
Oh.
Train. Homered last night. Added another hit as well. And fouled off.
Plus visual. Always good.
Comes up empty on
the minus visual.
Saw the fastball, but needed a step ladder to get to that one. It's going to have to tighten it back up. He wants to have a good at bat.
I made contact at least.
She's outside.
One, two.
Just missed. It's a good take.
Hey, little fly up there, huh?
Righty to the plate. Base hit center.
That's an RBI. There we go.
A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off. The deeper he gets into a count,
that's another thing, plate discipline. If you strike out and it's because it was you swung at stupid pitches, doesn't matter. If you didn't swing at a couple of them, you will lose plate discipline. And I don't know exactly what visual and plate discipline does for your character, like what stats it messes with. But it is good to keep those in the green instead of red.
On the ground to first, could be two. On a second, they get one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play. Nicely done, and that'll give them two runs for him, and they jump ahead. Bottom half of inning number one coming up.
I mean, that was a good double play. There's nothing I could have done.
The 3-1. Out to short. Train collects it. The throw to first. Play made. That ends the inning.
My arm being so low is bad. Because if somebody's fast enough, they can then beat my throw out. I was late there. I was not gonna lie. I was expecting it to drop.
18 years old, and he was a third round pick in 2020.
Third round, okay.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings.
That was stupid.
Right here. He's gonna try to make a
that was stupid.
Or a ground ball double play. Next offering misses, and it's 1-2. Runners are at the corners, one away. Next pitch misses. Ball two.
Hey, let it fly up there, huh?
Here we go. Just let it come back slowly.
Rolled to short.
That's a double.
One at second, and they bounce in.
I don't have the speed to beat that.
This one ends the third. No runs on two hits. No errors. And one. Welcome back as we go to the last of the third. Here's the third baseman, James Nelson. Bounced out to short.
One up, one down.
Your reaction very rarely is going to go down. As long as you just move towards the right direction. That will tell you which direction to move in as well.
And that one is lifted in the air. Number 10, gliding as he moves to his left.
Dang.
Makes a nice running catch.
Didn't drift as much as I would have liked to. Got an RBI though and advanced a run mark. It's good enough. Bottom of the fifth, we're up 8-0.
Here's your one. On the ground. Train picks it up. Fires across the diamond. Gets him easily, ends the inning. No runs on two hits. And welcome back. We go to the top of the seventh. And now the shortstop, Crash Train.
One for two. The sac fly doesn't count. Which, eh.
Out towards left side.
Oh, come on.
Drifts towards it. Makes the grab, one away.
It wasn't the prettiest of contact.
Back here at the ballpark, and now the catcher comes up.
But it was still a possibility. I think I'm going to be a pull hitter in this one.
Train settles under this one.
In 22, I was more push. I think I'm going to be more pull this time because I've kind of been running early every single time I've hit.
And now it's 1-2. Up the middle, Train handles the chance.
See, right. Honestly, I wasn't expecting to get him. That's where you want high arm because then that's just an easier throw to you for you to make.
For three. And first offering is fouled off. Gomez goes 6 feet, 3 inches. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, and he works in a two-seamer. To the right side. Sends it to first.
The bat sounds of this game as well. Improvement from 22. They sound much more solid than they did last game. Last game, it was very much just a deep thud, no matter how you hit it. And with this game, you can very much hear the difference between good contact and poor.
After a couple of times through the order, these guys really figured it out with the bats. A huge fifth inning, and that was all they really...
You also will run through these games really quickly. With... Either way, which way you play, whether you're a pitcher or a hitter... These games will be ran through very quickly, so like, pretty sure I did almost like a whole entire month per episode when I did 21. Which case is another thing we might do here. Because otherwise it's going to be like one game is going to last, it's been lasting like 5 minutes if even. In which case you get like, you can get 12 games in, which is like half a month. Also, a 3.75 average, that is not too bad, considering that I've been off MLB for a while. Is that a double RBI? Let's go.
Stringing them together, that's three hits in a row. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you gotta make them pay.
Left-hand hitter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Number four, gliding to his left, pulls it in on the run. And there's two down.
Now, one thing which they had in 22, which I hope they kind of carried over, was that opposite team fielders were not like Superman, where they'd make these unbelievable catchers or just catches or run like incredible speeds to get a pop out. But only time will tell.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Crash Train.
Oh yeah, my first dynamic challenge. Drive in a run. Power swing to drive in the run. I'm just gonna go for drive in the run.
Think about it. There's a chance to really blow this thing open right here.
Because I kinda just wanna like increase stats for now.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Big moment in this game. Two outs, two runners in scoring position, and could really break this thing wide open early.
This to third.
Nope.
Nelson, gloves.
That's an out.
Throws across the diamond.
Dang it. Didn't win the first challenge I got. But I also went for the easiest as well.
Alexander Vargas.
Dude, since when did you switch from NASCAR?
Train handles. Barely got it for the out close play. So up next, Jesus Bastidas. One for one with a single so far.
This is double play opportunity.
Ground ball up the middle, and that squirts through.
Gets him a little closer.
Let it through.
Welcome back. And now here is.
Oh god, now they're winning for once.
And a pitch. There's a strike.
Ooh. That was slow.
Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
0-2 as he waves at that one.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
Line drive, base hit. Off to a
good start. Yep, they're not Superman. That's one way to tell they're not Superman.
Ball in play with two strikes. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and ripped it into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Cracks his bat and pops him up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. So digging in, James Wood. He's already homered here in this one.
Come on, James. Do it again.
The 1-2. To first, maybe a two.
That's a double play.
First double play, and that's the inning.
If he was a little bit further off the bag towards second base, might have been able for him to keep on base. I was out either way.
Swing and a bouncer. Train collects it. Slings to first, and now two gone. So here's the cleanup hitter. Crash Train.
Come at me, mate. What you got?
Foul ball there.
Also loved how I said I might be a pull hitter and I'm still running late on pitches.
And that one fouled off. Harris, the runner at first with two gone.
Weak contact, and it, see, it even says contact, and then it takes away power.
Next pitch way upstairs.
Also, I love the fact about why it's adjusting your stats. Like, it gives a reason. It's not just like, yeah, down, up, down. That's a double. Nope. I thought I had more time than I did.
And now the first baseman, number 10, for the fourth time tonight. Two on, two outs. Ground ball right side. He steps on the bag, and that is that. This one pretty well decided.
Yeah, we've lost this one big time. 4-12. Ouch. Oh, Lord.
Ripped to short. Train collects. In plenty of time to first. Now two out.
The left fielder, number four.
So they're down to their final out.
One last hit. Can I go 800 this game? Or am I going to be six?
Going to the opposite field.
In there for strike one. Norwood, 29 years old. He joined the team as a free agent. And there's a foul ball.
Gotta be smart.
Good job to fight that one off.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
This man's just throwing straight heater. Oh, I'm also the last possible out.
Battling here as he fouls it away.
Defend your plate flare. That's an out. Pop up. Oh, batted 600 that game. That's not too shabby. That's also it for the series. 3-for-5, 2 RBIs. They called that. Oh, I'd see. That's more of a pop out than a line out, but okay. Perk. Yes. Gonna open up that immediately. Let's see, how do I get to my packs? Man, overview. Collection, there it is. Perk pack, we don't care about the show pack right now. Already have a... Ooh. Breaking pitch, kind of meh. They were both breaking pitch. They were both pitching attributes, which is not the best. However, I do have a perk I can edit. I believe, yep, fielding 3. Gives me more accuracy. Of course it's gonna make me check that. Below average in fielding. Wow. So, next series. Richmond, I don't remember. Oh, okay. If you're looking to maximize development as a hitter, batting cage is open. Days off are your own. Just the basic stuff. Batting cage. Yes, I want to exit the tutorial. I know how to do this. Okay, let's see. Plate vision, bunting, contact. Again, I don't know what plate vision necessarily does. Flying squirrels, I don't know which double A team that is. It's not the Orioles. It's not the Nationals, because I'm with the Nationals. St. Louis, I doubt though. Because Richmond's Virginia. That's the main Richmond you think of, at least. I don't know where it is. I can't think about it.
Number 89, now at the plate.
Okay, double play.
Hit on the ground might be two. To second, that's one. And it's a double play.
There you go. Keep on building up that arm strength, please.
The batter will be the shortstop. Crash train. On the ground to third.
Early and chopped it.
Whips it across, and that's the inning.
Chopped it like hell.
So two away with nobody on. At the plate. Jairo Pomares. And here it comes. up the middle. Train handles the chance on the run.
Might not make it.
Over to first.
Got him.
But two runs for him and they jump ahead. Now to one gone runner at first. Now the number two hitter, number 89. He's 0 for 1. Here comes a pitch. On the ground is short, could be
that's
two.
Just a flick. I don't, you don't really got to aim on those, which is just like a small flick when you're right up against the base, thankfully. Because it kind of just wastes time to me. There's like no need for it. You're right there next to the guy.
First pitch, not close. Train, only 18 years old, and he was a third round pick in 2023. Swing and that ball smashed on a
drop,
line.
Drop.
Dives, but it's off his glove. Base hit. The throw in.
This is gonna be close. Nope. Out. Just not fast enough. It still counts as a hit. No, that's gonna take away my speed and base running aggression. Can't remember if it actually takes away from speed, but I know it takes away your base aggression. The little animations and like HUD for this game is just amazing. Oh wow.
Got some runs across. This is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Okay, Flair, defend your plate.
Foul ball, it stays nothing in two.
That's a hit.
The middle and it gets through.
I'd say a mistake pitch in an 0-2 count. Too good of a pitch to hit right there. You have to expand the zone. Keep that leadoff man off first base.
And here is number 6. A strikeout and a walk.
Don't even throw to first, dude. Come on.
Tap to first.
That's a double.
Feed to second, that's one. Back to the pitcher covering in time. It's a double play.
The 3-6-1 double play, in my opinion, one of the toughest plays to make. You've got a pitcher covering first and the middle infield.
Two outs, runner at first. Now, Patrick Bailey, a switch hitter batting right. And now the lefty out to short. Train over to pick it up. Zips it across.
Just take some time.
So it's no runs on no hit. One down. And next will be the cleanup hitter. Crash Train. And he swings.
Ooh.
This is at the initial offering. Bivens.
That was slow.
He joined the team as a free agent. Right-handed reliever, and that one sliced foul. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah, a little slider action.
Hey, come on, big guy, get your pitch.
And the next pitch is way outside.
Four seam, way gone.
Out of the zone, gives the hitter a little confidence that maybe he can climb back into this at bat.
Kicks and deals.
That's another hit.
That's a base hit.
Really nice job of two
strikes. I don't care if it's only like singles, as long as I just consistently get hits, I'm actually kind of fine with it.
There's just no one there to knock it down.
Pickoff throw. Train.
You're not gonna pick me off, dude. Come on.
As well. Train over at first with one away.
Stop throwing it. I'm too big.
Again to first.
No, he's safe.
And no luck this time either.
Just let me take my step and pitch. Okay, man, come on.
And another move.
No, he's safe.
And a shocking development. He's safe again. Left field, Pomares settles underneath it. He's got it. Two away.
I went for it. Manager steal situation. Yeah, I know it's a steal situation.
There goes the runner. Pitch in for a strike.
I'm gonna get out.
Throw to second. Out there. And that ends
the. It's gonna take away from my steal. I believe.
Catch and throw to end the inning. That's the way to pick up the pitcher.
I mean, I had a good reflex. You want to go like as soon as he starts his wind up to give you the greatest chance. But it's just a little bit too slow right now.
Bounce to the left side. Tosses to first. That's the third out. So no runs on no hits, no errors, and one man left. Home half of inning number 8.
Why are you checking my man's glove, huh? What y'all thinking he's doing?
First offering misses badly for ball one.
Well, this is a critical spot for both the pitcher and the hitter. You can learn a lot about a guy by how he handles these pressure situations.
And now it's even up.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Good two speed.
So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second.
Hey, keep it going up there. Your turn, your turn.
That smashed.
That's an out.
Bishop makes the catch, and that'll do it.
I got my.
Isan Diaz up to hit now.
If I can hit this double play, that's game over. We win.
Out to short, Train. One at second. Out. The double play ends it right here.
There we go. I actually, for a second, I thought that pulled him off the bag, to be honest. But I guess he stayed on just long enough that, or he tagged the dude as he was leaving. Contact decrease, of course. We handed them their first loss. Guess that's something.
Now it's going to be Crash Train. One of the stars in the win yesterday as he had three hits. That's towards center.
That's an out. Not just not enough power.
Down and there's two gone. A speed threat.
Just not enough power, not enough speed. I really can't do anything. I mean, it is the minor leagues fresh ball player, so it's kind of expected.
Ground ball right side could be two. Fires to second for one. Return throw to first, and that's two.
For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn.
Now the batter will be the shortstop.
That one's not a tough double play.
Flied out to center in his first at bat. That one fouled off. Beck, 26 years old, and he was drafted in the fourth round back in 2018.
Oh, Lord.
Two now. Not a swing you want to watch again.
That was a nasty 12-6.
Line drive, base go. Hit right center field.
There we go. That's an RBI at least.
Here's the throw to the plate. Not in time, he scores. And now just a two-run deficit.
Good two-strike hitting right there, Boog. A bit of a loss. start for some, so that was nicely done to beat the odds. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home run.
Checks over to first, back safely. Two two now. Right side. He'll do it himself.
Easy out for him.
Spare, and that's the inning. A run on two hits, and they lead one. Three innings complete. The Flying Squirrels out front here. Three. Isan Diaz up to hit now. He's already
over here. Oh, Jesus, guys.
Ground ball left side, could be two. Fired to second. Double play. And that'll do it for the inning. So it's one run.
Still love the fact that I, even though I wasn't really throwing the ball, I got arm power for it.
Swings through that one. 0-1.
It's just been an impressive outing so far. Continues to pound the zone pitch after pitch. And he's been able to stay down. That's what's been key.
Lined into right.
Drop.
No trouble here. Puts it away for the
end. Okay, they might have the Superman powers back.
So now it's the four-hole hitter. Crash Train. 1-3.
Got just a one run all game.
And a foul ball. The pitch. Base knock, center field. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Now that
pretty deep on him, so
I want him to start off.
Speed and inside though, so a good adjustment to shoot it back up the middle.
On the ground, nope. Right side, Diaz picks it up. That's the inning.
This one, well, that's all I've got for hitting.
Runner at first, no, two away. And now Brett,
unless we somehow miraculously get through the whole order of the
pitch. Hit hard on the ground short.
Now, I could have made that throw to second, but just go to first. That way, not, you have the least amount of possibility of a fuck up. Yep.
Always nice when you can win by a touchdown or a couple of field goals. Keep that momentum going, knowing the offense can score at will. Bring it into the next one and get another W.
There we go. Everything goes up. So, what I think for this first stream, we're gonna at least go through the series with Akron, and then whatever packs I get, I will open those up. If it's not a perk pack, at least if it's a perk pack, I will almost definitely open those up immediately. But like all my show packs and all that, I'll open up at the end of the stream after we've gone through like all the games that we were gonna got scheduled for the stream. I think a solid like 12 or 16 games per stream is going to be what I do, unless it's like going by really fast or like really slow.
I think you have to remember and take the opportunity when you do struggle to really look yourself in the mirror, identify what went wrong, and make improvements. And I have no doubt that that's what this guy did in the offseason to prepare himself.
I'm batting 500, that's not bad. Single or better, double, power swing for a hit. Just go single or better. Keep it safe for now.
And he deals. And that one wrapped foul.
Oof. That, yep. That's my nemesis. Those sliders.
For that strikeout, keep him off balance. Send him back to the dugout.
Next one is off the play. And a count 1-2. And that chance handled. Over to first. And quickly.
And that was poor contact. That's all that was just poor contact.
Grounded out back to the pitcher his first time. first offering, and it just misses. Murphy, 6'1" righty, 23 years old, and he was a fifth round pick in 2020.
There we go, that's solid contact. Towards right center field, that'll touch down for a hit. Bishop, but not enough speed. Throw back in as the stop sign goes up at third. First and third, two away. And now, I have a feeling we're losing this game again.
He walked and came around to score his first time up. On the ground to the left. They take the force out. That ends the inning. So they strand a pair. On to inning number four. The flying squirrels. Brett Auerbach, the next to hit. Second baseman, Brett Auerbach. So now 3-2. Out to short. Boots it.
Safe at first. Just grab the ball. Can't make the play. How did...
All right, we go to the top half of inning number six.
Thankfully, they didn't score off that.
Patrick Bailey. Hit weakly on the ground. On the run, throw to first. And a quick out number one.
Good fastball. In a...
Bottom of the six. Here's the
6-11 in the series isn't too bad.
Murphy back to work. That to right. And it's caught for the out.
6-12 on the series.
And next will be the cleanup hitter. Crash Train. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
Next offering is...
Oh, wow.
This guy's pounding the zone. Hitters don't have time to think in between pitches.
Now a screamer into the outfield. Gigliotti makes the catch, and that'll do it. 9-1 is
they kind of whooped our asses there. They really whooped our asses there.
Thanks for stopping by. I'm John Schomburg. And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Some double-A baseball coming at you. It's the Richmond Flying Squirrels and the Harrisburg Senators. All right, we'll be back to get this.
Ay, ay, ay. Oh, yo, Smiles. If I ever was able to throw a first pitch, I feel like I could be very good at it.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Michael Gigliotti. On the ground to short. Throw to first is in time. One out in the top of the first. Here's Will Wilson.
Dude's name Gigliotti. That's funny.
Ground ball left side. Train collects it. Fires over to first. Third out, and that ends the frame. End of a half inning of play. At first, now it's the shortstop. Crash Train.
There we go. One pitch, one hit. 7-14.
Now just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands. You let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
He takes it himself to the
back. Hit that on a screamer to first base.
Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. Now it's the DH, Isan Diaz. Up the middle, Train handles. Gathers and throws to first. One up, one down. And here's the catcher, Patrick Bailey.
Hey,
a switch hitter batting right.
Hey, let's roll two. Plays it two.
2-2 down. On the ground, a second might be two. There's one.
Nope, that's only going to be one.
What
Surprised. Typically, if he gets it that late and he takes that long, it's only one.
He's already singled in this game. Out to short.
And that's two singles this game.
They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
Ready to hit right there. Just one of those seen high base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ball game.
And again, as soon as I get on base, the next hitter gets out. Ground up to first. Can't get him home. Three innings complete.
Isan Diaz up to hit.
Back onto the field. Steal 0-0.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a ground ball out to short.
You know what? I respect that from the third baseman trying to lay down and didn't get the out. I would have been slightly pissed.
Now here is Michael.
Only took five innings to get the first run of the game.
He'll score. It's 2-0.
Well, here we are, third time through.
I don't know what they were expecting me to do that with that. Yikes.
Black back to work. Ball one, no strikes.
You know, this group of hitters need to bring up the quality of their bats and specifically their swings. They're trying to find ways to drive the ball with some authority, but it's just not happening for them so far.
Nope. There goes the streak. Well, at bat hit streak at least. Still have a 3-game hitting streak. Hey, look at that. We got some runs on the board.
First pitch just misses.
To be honest, that should have been a strike.
Man at second. Line drive. And a base hit. Fox around third. Here comes the throw. The run comes in from second, and they cut the lead to two. Throw pulls him off the bag, and he's safe.
That was good.
Tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that
dead zone. Got me with that.
Executed on time with everything, and pulled it into the gap nicely.
Roby picks it up. Inning over. Three runs on four hits, no errors, and one left on. We look ahead to inning number 8. The flying score. So digging in, crash,
trail. Oh, yay. Either I lose it all for us here, or I give us another fighting chance.
Dabovich, a 6-3 righty. He features a 4-seam fastball, a curve, a changeup, and he works in a 2-seamer. Next offering way off the plate.
Nah, get me with that curve again, mate. Ouch. You got me with the curve. He got me with the curve.
John Chambi saying, so long.
Vanguard final line score. First for the victorious visiting team. 5 runs, 7 hits, 1 error. They left 6 men on base.
This should be the last game of this series, at least. And then we've got Akron. Then we're going to cut it there. And then at 6:45 today, guys, second stream of the day, Bang Energy Cup Series is coming back. NASCAR Heat 5 finally has those servers fixed. We're able to go back league. Oh my lord, that was horrible. We're finally able to go back league racing, so I'm going to be excited to bring those streams back.
Jackson Rutledge.
Well, he issued way too many free passes this last time out. You can't win at this level if you allow that many base runners. So today, he's got to get strike one, put the hitter on his heels, maybe get some swings. In.
Oh, now this ball's going to get through, and that's a base hit. In to score is the runner from third.
It's tying RBI, okay. Not just RBI, the tying one.
Designated hitter, number 42.
How did I go to 48? Oh, it's Jackie Robinson game.
To the right side, Diaz. Gloves.
So in case any of y'all don't know,
that's the third out.
Every, like,
so a run on one hit, no error
towards the beginning of the season, one of the first, like, 20 games is a Jackie Robinson honor game because of what Jackie did for the league and everything, to where they honor him by everyone wearing his number 42.
Single that drove in a run his first time. There and it's 0-1.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound.
This guy's a slider.
Yeah. Where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
Slice the other way and foul. Next pitch just misses, and that's ball one.
Sliders are my worst nightmare.
The ground out to short.
With like normal breaking pitches, I don't know why I can hit them fine, but when it comes to a slider, I just suck. I don't know why. Also, AOS Jedi, thanks for the follow, mate. Love it. Love the Jedi part. I am a Star Wars geek.
Hit on the ground to the right side. It's through for a hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, he found himself behind in the count.
Good. Question for you. What would be your favorite Trooper Battalion from the Clone Wars days?
And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has...
Ooh, if I was on time there, that was gone.
...can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Harris, over at second, one down.
With the Bad Batch? Okay, you know what, I'll take that. The Bad Batch were good. And I just... I struck out reading chat. The Bad Batch are good. Honestly, they are solid.
Here is Patrick Bailey. Signs back to work. Bounce to the left side. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
They've got my boy Echo from the 501st, which is one reason why I like them. Another one is just because they're all like specialty deformities. Mutation, clones.
Facing a left-handed pitcher, what you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
On the ground a second, might be two. There's one. On to first, double play.
Barely got that one off.
So one out, nobody on. Crash Train digs in now, one for three. And a pitch. Good eye right there. Tang, the tall righty. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a changeup, and he occasionally uses a curve. That one misses.
That should have been a strike.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt.
I was expecting that to keep on moving outside. That's why I didn't swing.
Big impact for him in recent games.
That was stupid.
The count now 2-1. One down, base is empty. That one fouled off.
Defend your plate, Flair. Defend your plate.
The pitch.
Thank you. All right, come on now. One time. Let it fly.
Now this is in the air down the line.
Patiently waiting for the Ahsoka series. Yeah. I kind of want to see where they go with Ahsoka's character, to be honest, because she's one of the most developed characters in any Star Wars media.
Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Headed for the plate.
I'm also kind of wishing to see what they did, because it's rumored. I don't know if it's like completely, I know it's a big rumor. I'm not sure if it's a complete 100% thing, but say that like Ezra and Admiral Thrawn are supposed to be in it, and you get to see what they did with, or get to see what happened while they were out in hyperspace. Then we also get Sabine back, of course.
Could be two. Over to second for one. Return throw to first. Got him. Double play. And that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark. And the batter now, Ford Proctor. Here's a tapper towards short. Train handles the chance. Whips it to first on the run. Roll save. And that was close.
Need more arm power.
Good throw, but the
don't have the arm strength.
On that one, as far as you had to go and throw, you know? Yeah, no question. Ground ball could be two. And that one handled. Can't hang on.
Oh, wow.
First.
Though he didn't recognize change up.
Let's
earlier.
Let's see. Two between Return of the Jedi and Force Awakens. That would be good show. I think they've already commented what he was doing between the two points through The Mandalorian, where he was rebuilding the temple, though they'll probably will show more of that. I think, here's my theory at least, that if they do include Ezra, that Ahsoka will be, yes, Butterfingers. Is that if they do include Ezra, I think Ahsoka's going to bring him to the temple that Luke has. Now, if you want to talk about, like, post-Return of the Jedi, that's non-canon, is now Legends, there's a million books. Oh, wow, yep. Superman Defender Fielders. Oh, I haven't read in a while. At least the legacy, the Legends books. My dad used to have just about every single one, I think. I think they're all out in the dining room, cabinets, dining room cupboard.
Nothing doing here this half. We head down to the home half of inning number three.
Is it novels on like the new canon, or is it all just the Legends, Legends books? Back gone. I'm out.
Fires to first on the run. They don't come much closer.
Almost beat it, to be fair.
Runner on at first with one gone.
Oh, for two.
Crash train. In the air right side.
Straight to him.
Makes the grab for the second out.
Oh, this game of the series is going so poorly. But we're winning.
First and second, two outs. Digging in, Ford Proctor, one for two. On the ground. Fires over to first. That's out number three. No runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Midway in inning number seven, and it's time. So now here's the DH, Michael Gigliotti, corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. And a pitch. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
Well, a big swing of the bat right there. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much.
Welcome back. Now it's the shortstop, Crash Train.
Okay, come on, I at least gotta win one challenge this stream.
The wind of the pitch. Chopped out front of the
nope.
To first.
Dang it.
Out here in the eighth.
start a winning streak from here. And your final.
Now to Ohio. The land down under within the U.S. Ooh, new perks.
Baseball's the best game because baseball does not have a clock. At its highest level, the drama unfolds because there is no clock to bail a team out. 27 up, 27 down.
Not true anymore because of the pitch clock, which I see why they did it. They retired games going like 4 or 5 hours, but the pitch clock is like weird because of how it works. There's just so much rules with it that I think is stupid. Ooh, I get it. It's a choice perk pack. Okay. No, it's not even a perk pack. That. Anyways. Last series of the stream. Bench coach, when time allows, player, many players will work to improve themselves in training facility or practice field. There we go. Now every form of practice is unlocked. Arm accuracy, arm strength. Yes, please. Give me arm strength, please. Because if I can't hit, I don't care as much. As long as I'm good at fielding. Because fieldings, for some reason, will kind of progress you further and give you a higher chance of getting into the majors and getting promoted. Again, these cutscenes, man. Cover design, these, I love them. It's way better than just blandness that you had on MLB 22. Power swing to drive in a run, hit a home run, only swing at pitches inside the zone and hit in the run. Let's go with this one. That's an out. Nope. I thought it was an out, so I kept my finger pressed forward. At least we got the run, and I got the hit, though. I want to challenge the first stream. I'm happy. But we are losing to Akron. Two hits in a row. Don't let stick drift catch me out with that one. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna push hitter again. That's a double. That was close.
And here's the first baseman, number 6. 1-for-1 with a single so far. At the belt fires. Swing and a pop up. Delgado. Has this one sized up? That's out number 2.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but.
Come on, Wood. Basis.
Two outs, bases full. Here's Carter Kieble. Carter struck out swinging his first time. Here's a 3-0. Ball four.
Wow. Score on a walk. Oh, cheers. Also, join the Discord, link to the account, link to my Twitch. You'll see a nice little Easter egg if you're a Star Wars geek. And yes, do try to join that stream. It is wild. I think we've got 6 racers tonight. We might have more, might have less. But have fun, do whatever you gotta do, because after this I gotta start dinner as well. Solid hits this game. Yes.
He scores. It's 5-3 to third, not in time. And it's runners at the corners with one gone. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, TJ White. The switch hitter batting right. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third.
Dang. Couldn't get any more off of that.
Two outs, nobody up. Number 6 will hit next. 0-1, he struck out swinging last time. That one the other way. No trouble here.
Nice catch, mate.
And that ends the inning. And welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the
Jose Tenna. Don't know why I added an unnecessary why.
And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. Now batting. So the lineup flips over. Raynel Delgado now at the plate. 2-1. Bounced out to short. Train collects it. Tosses to first. It's over. So they go quietly there. The two outs, base is empty. And now the center fielder, Petey Halpin. He's already homered in this game. Bounced up the middle. Train picks it up. Throws the first. That is
there we go, solid fielding this time. No more Butterfingers, please. Don't get me wrong, I like the candy, but I prefer not to have them. Nope. Again, I'll never understand why, if it says it's weak contact, why that will take off power. It says contact, not weak power, it says weak contact. I believe it's bumper to dive. I gotta remember that as well. We'll kind of keep stuff like that. Nope. See, poor contact. It says contact. Contact gets infected. How it should be. And we lost. Oh, my lord, we lost Ohio. I don't hate Ohio, trust me, I don't. I have the reason why I'm a Cleveland fan. Family's from Ohio, I don't hate them. It's a nice place. It's a nice place, especially the area where my family is. Just play with the joke a little bit. Four and six, man. There we go. Hit off the bat. Well, host it, Griff. Calm down. .48 on base, .48 on mound. I didn't even take a lead, dude. You're not gonna get me. You can't get me if I take the lead. You're not gonna get me then. Dude, I'm 6'6". You're not gonna pick me off that easily. Nope. Still almost made it. Trying to hit me, mate.
Playing up the middle at short, batting in the cleanup spot, and he's driven in double-digit runs over his last 10 games. The other way, takes it.
Damn, mine out to first.
Top six, and now the shortstop crash train. Why the kick the pitch? That one drifts inside. Williams, a 6'6 righty. 23 years old, a former first-round pick in 2021. Ground ball up the middle. Sends it to first. Now one.
I'm almost beating these throws, to be honest.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Crash train for the fourth time tonight.
Nope. Good contact. Decently ahead, but just no power. That was a fast game. I think that first home run that first game was just kind of lucky, to be honest. That was embarrassing.
Third, Gonzalez handles. Lead off in the
There's the nasty sliders. Like I said, the nasty sliders. Doesn't even have to worry about me hitting it through the outfield. Just ground out. Okay, so yeah, I was right. It is bumper to dive. And that kind of costs for a run. Submarine pitcher with a slider, that's even worse. And a sinker. What does he have? Slider, sinker, changeup, 4 and a 2. Okay. The dangerous arsenal. Had me all tied up. And that was probably my last at bat as well. I shouldn't even try to get the double play. There's just no use. I know I've been talking about the cutscenes, but I'm kind of rushing them. Contact swing to advance runner. You know what? That is one I will take. That's bullshit, ref. I'll take that, considering I had no hits last game. I'll take that. I could probably have made it to third, but I'm not gonna try it. What was that?
So here's the clue. Just,
what the absolute fuck was that?
The wind and the pitch.
Is that gone? off the scoreboard. If that wasn't a scoreboard, that would have been two home runs within the first stream, and I would have been ecstatic. So I think to get a home run, I just have to have the ball in a certain space.
Just off the inside edge.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
And a four pitch.
Man, he does walk him.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
So up next, James Wood. One for two. He had an RBI base hit back in the first. In the air, fairly deep to right field. No trouble here.
Dang.
It away for the out. And that is the third out of the inning. So it's no runs on a hit. Here's the shortstop at the plate. Crash train.
Hey, don't be afraid. Let it fly one time.
You know what? Driving a runner. Let's do it.
Swing.
That won't do it, though.
Zips it to first. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. Three runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. 8-9-1 scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. Now it's the shortstop, Crash Train.
Crash Train.
Here you go, let it fly now.
Kelly back to work. Swing and a base hit. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock. So digging in, number 10, one for three. Hit in the air, right field. Number 32, under this one, makes the catch, inning over.
It's okay, mate.
Oh,
we gotta shut him down here for at least a chance, and over. We got into overtime at least.
Crash Train.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
The pitch. Taps softly.
That's not going to be a run scored. Advance the runner at least, but that's not challenge complete.
Nice job with the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent.
Got to shut down here to continue extra innings. And extra innings will continue. And we lost an extra innings. They got a walk off. It was still good. That's a lot of stats to gain. So hard to beat. That is so dang hard to beat. As long as the pitcher just doesn't completely fluff it up. If he had caught that, I would have been pissed. I mean, I'm sorry, but no. Look, I know you can see me at least, and you have a little bit easier of a pickoff throw, but I'm still 6'6". So far underneath it, even though it auto moves to that area, it was so far underneath. Sliders, yeah. Keep going. That would have been us taking the lead. These Akron games are going by pretty damn quick. I should have batting gloves on.
Line drive and puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two. Now it's the right fielder, Jorge.
Where are my batting gloves?
He's been struggling so far this year. It's only late April, but still hoping he'll turn it around soon. Popped up. And there are two down.
I mean, it's first day of release. There's guaranteed to be some glitches, so I might just have to go and reapply them. Don't even try for a second, man.
Singled in this game.
On the ground, out to short. Tosses to first, and there are two outs. As we go to the top of the fourth. Now it's the shortstop, Crash Train.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Come on, let it fly right here.
And here it comes. There's a strike.
He's been pitching well, but we'll see what kind of adjustment the hitters make this second time through the order. We'll know if he's got really good stuff in this one or not.
Lined, and that's a base hit. Number six digs in now.
Okay.
His first time.
I'm going to get a couple solid challenges at least.
Check on the runner, and he dives back in safely.
Don't try to pick me off. Y'all are going to have to just learn this. I'm too big for y'all.
Another throw over, and he's back again. Back to first. And once again, he's
eventually he'll just ignore me. See, eventually he'll just ignore me.
Short, and it gets by him. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air. Shallow left field. Base hit. The run comes in from second. It's 2-2.
Solid RBI, Wood. Good job.
I'm not going to leave this field.
Now batting. So two down, and now the shortstop, Crash Train. One for two. That one is absolutely belted. Way back there.
That's a double.
One hops off the wall. And that's a two-out double.
No way I was making that a triple. I'd have to push into the opposite field corner.
Number six, getting ready to hit. Two outs. And that's ball four. James Wood, the next to hit. Two on, two outs. Center field. And that'll do it. So they strand a pitch. So here's the cleanup hitter, Crash Train. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Finally got a new pitcher in.
Ground ball left side, and that's just foul. Ripped on a line.
Drop, drop, drop. That's the game won, and the series finished. So, that's all the games for today. We're going to open up these couple of packs, and then that's going to be it for this stream. I'll be back in a little under 2 hours for some Bang Energy Cup Series. But let's get these packs done. We've got three to open. See if we can get anything good.
2008 gold. Glove Award winner Carlos Pena joins me. Carlos, what are some ways to improve your reaction time in the field? And
oh, it's only two packs. Okay.
You know, there's a,
so this.
People talk about, hey, fielding is all about having great hands.
So that's either a contract, so a piece of equipment, or
footwork, that first step is you always have
stadium uniform.
So get going,
bronze player, bronze.
Expecting a play,
I think that's just a normal card, and a
step,
silver.
You always have to be in motion.
Sound. That ain't bad. Now this, kind of what I'm expect. This is what I need. Contactor power. Includes and arm strength. Sorry, once it said arm strength, I was done. I need that, please. But yeah, that's all we got today, guys. It's been nearly a 2-hour stream. Started off our road to the show, and hopefully once we do get with the Nationals, we'll be able to get a championship with them. That is the end goal. But like I said, come back here in about 2 hours. You'll be catching the Bang Energy Cup Series League Racing on NASCAR Heat 5. There's 6 or 7 of us ready to go for it. We've been expecting it. We've been begging for the 704 games to get the game fixed to where we can do online league races again, and they have finally after nearly a month. But uchu kawaka waka, tricky fellas, and I'll catch y'all next time.